Very good, Mike. And, you live here in Nashville?
Yeah, I've been here for 13 years. A little
13
over.
Years.
About 10 and a half.
It's a nice town, isn't it?
Oh, I love it.
Yeah, I do too.
I love the history. I'm a real, in addition to being a music buff, I'm a history buff.
And right.
I grew up in the Northeast around, not very far from Gettysburg Battlefield in Pennsylvania. So the town I grew up in is very historic and close to another historic town and not far from the battlefield. And so I love history in general, and Nashville's history is wonderful. And then country music, being a musician since I was 12, is just so rich, and this particular block, people just don't have any idea. They're walking right in the footsteps of the giants.
You're right.
I mean, they literally are. They have no idea. Places like Lime Balls that are no longer here, Waylon hanging out and playing pinball and like Lime Balls. Marty Robbins writing, drinking coffee and smoking cigarette blues at the old Demon's Den, stuff like that. People don't know about all that stuff, and they're walking right through the middle of it. It's a shame that when they go through the Hall of Fame or they go through a Ryman tour, that they don't get more about what happened right here. It would enrich their experience so much. I did a YouTube page towards that end, and it's still up. If you get on YouTube and you go to Nashville's, with a plural, mandolin, all one word, lowercase, and then you scroll down, you see a picture of me. There's a bunch of other people on that page. But you scroll down, you see a picture of me, and click on there. There's 120 minutes of video, and it's all around downtown. It's stories like that.
Tell me that name again, that page?
Nashville's Mandolin.
Nashville's Mandolin.
Right, and it's just all lowercase, one word, and on YouTube. So if you already subscribed to YouTube, you're already there. And there's nothing else. You have to subscribe to the site to access the videos, but there's no money involved, and it's not going to send you to anything.
I understand.
It's totally free. And I'm really all about the history, and I'm really all about passing on the knowledge. And I love the kids, and I love playing for the kids, because, there's our future. If one of them picks up an instrument because of the interactive experience, art stays alive.
Right.
And without that, it dies. And we live in an age where it's already possible to sample everything that's ever been done. We're almost to the point where nobody has a reason to learn to play anymore.
Yeah.
And it's scary, so I feel it's so important to pass it on to the young folks,
I agree.
That's really what it's all about, of course, I want to play the Ryman. I know, I don't care about being on CMT or being a star, but I would love to play the Ryman. I'd love to be able to tour and make enough money to be comfortable, but in the meantime, it's really important to do what I do because of the preservation. That's what it's all about to me. So towards that end, I'll do a little Jimmie Rodgers music.